an English lesson in an Israeli Arabic school in the lower grades. It is 7:30 in the morning. The children are assembled in the classroom. The teacher enters. Everyone stands up. The teacher says,
"Good morning, my dear children. Please sit down. يعني اجلسوا يا أولاد. Today, يعني unlike yesterday or tomorrow, today, present. Now, I am going to tell you the most beautiful story. This story was written, أيوة حميد, I shall explain it to you. Written, يعني كتبوا. You spell it WRITTEN. My dear Hamid, why two T's? I don't know, some T's. This story was written by a gentleman by the name of Mr. William Shakespeare. And my dear children, since I know that you are going to fall in love with this writer after you hear his most beautiful story, and since I do not want you to have any disillusions in the future يعني بكرة بعد بكرة, I will tell you right away, Mr. Shakespeare died. يعني مات, الله يرحمه. He died exactly in approximately a very long time ago. The name of the story is Mr. Hamlet. Now on with the story. Once, يعني upon a very long time ago, there was a gentleman by the name of Mr. Hamlet. He was a prince. يعني ابن ملك. Prince, B-R-I-N-C-E. Well, like not B, I said B. Not B like butter, but B like Bibel. And now, this Mr. Hamlet was a prince. He lived in Denmark. Denmark, where it is? It is exactly, approximately, it is on the other side of the ocean. But if you please remind me tomorrow to show you Denmark, where it is on the geographical map. Mr. Hamlet was a prince, and he had a mother who was a queen of Denmark. And of course, if he had a mother, he had a father. Otherwise, no Hamlet. My dear Hamid, do you think that your teacher has nothing to do but to come to this class and tell you jokes? Well, like these are historical facts. So take your finger out of your nose and have a little more respect for Mr. Shakespeare or Mr. Hamlet. Shame on you. Where is your education? Mr. Hamlet loved his mother, and his mother loved him. And they also respected each other. So it seems to us in the beginning of the story. But one day, the father of Mr. Hamlet, يعني the king of Denmark, died. How he died, we don't know yet, but we shall know later on in the story. So if you please, be patient. Now, the death of the father of Mr. Hamlet was a terrible shock for Mr. Hamlet. Why, my dear Hamid? That is correct. Because his father died. One day, it was very hot in the house. Mr. Hamlet went on the roof of the house to take some fresh air. يعني شمت الهواء. And he was walking here and there, respirating the fresh air and expiring the not fresh air. And as he was walking, all of a sudden, he looked up into the sky and saw a big black cloud. And in the cloud, he saw the feature of his father. But he was not sure whether it was his father or not. As a matter of fact, it was a doubtful. But nevertheless, so he looked up into the sky and said, Ya Baba Allah Wallahi, Baba Allah Wallahi, Baba Allah Wallahi. He was not sure. So he went down on his knees. And that is to tell you that in the ancient times, a father used to be a father. And not like in our times, where a father is a father. He went down on his knees for the respectation for his father. And here, my dear children, starts the most beautiful dialogue. But dialogue, Hamid? Yes, I shall explain. Dialogue, it is exactly like monologue, except in the case of monologue, it is one person talking to himself. Dialogue, two persons talking to themselves. Yes. This is number two. As I said, this is number two. Number one, which is more important, wanna take your nose out of your finger? And also reminds me that tomorrow I shall see your father here in the class. And your mother. On with the story. And here, my dear children, starts the most beautiful dialogue between the father of Mr. Hamlet, yani the late father, and Mr. Hamlet himself. This is one of the most beautiful soliloquies done by yani in dialogue. But it was also translated into English, and I shall recite this in the original. And his father said unto him,
Hamlet, ya ibni.
Which means, Hamlet, my son.
Innani abuka.
يعني, I am your father. Abuka mata. Your father died.
كيف مات أبوك؟
How he died?
قلوك إنه الخي أشتني بالليل وضربتني بأذني. يعني they told you إنه the snake came in the night and hit me in my ear. كذبين يا هملت كذبين.
يعني liars يا هملت liars. عمك قتل أبوك وجوز أمك. Which means your uncle killed your father and married your mother. Now this was a terrible shock for Mr. Hamlet. He took down his head, took hold of his knife and said, لا استريح حد الانتقام. يعني I shall not rest until I take revenge. And he lifted his head unto his father and said, يا بابا ولا بابا ولا بطيخ. His father disappeared back into the clouds. And here, my dear children, this bloody story about these bloodthirsty people is coming towards its end. So bloodthirsty were they that until today we don't know exactly who killed whom. So if you please go home and remember to come to the class and wash your hands and ears. And most of all, respect your father and your mother. And remind me tomorrow to show you Denmark where it is on the geographical map. Now go home and God bless you. Allahu ma'akum ya awlad.